it's me again. So today's theme is Disney. We're going to start off by doing a piece of artwork themed around Mickey Mouse. Then we're going to move on to a virtual ride together. Then we will have the magic trick. And then last but not least, of course, the fact of the day. So let's get on with it. Okay, so today we will be doing some artwork around the theme of Mickey Mouse. So to do this, you will need one piece of cardboard, some pins, some thread or yarn of your choice in any colour, something you can draw around which will make a rather large circle, and something that will make a smaller circle. You will also need a pencil. So this is how it works. First, you take your larger circle and you place it on top of your rectangle. Holding it down with your finger, you then draw a circle around the bowl or object that you've used. Okay. And there we have it. There's the first circle. Okay. Then you'll take your object, which will make a smaller circle, and you place it just above the circle that you've drawn on the cardboard here. And again, you draw around it. There's one. And then you're going to draw another one just on the other side. Now, what does that look like? It looks like Mickey Mouse's head. Okay? So now we have the shape. Now we're going to use the pins. We're going to take them out of their box here and put a few on the countertop. Be very careful with these because they are rather sharp. Okay, so you're going to hold them at the side which isn't sharp. And you're going to place them very carefully into the cardboard. Whoops. There's one. Okay, so this is what it looks like when it's done. After that, you're going to take your thread, okay? And I'm going to cut off, or just pull off, some of the thread. Ah, there we go. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to just make a little knot at the end of the thread. This is a bit tricky, so you may need help, okay? And that makes like a little loop at the end. You see that? Okay. I'm going to place that on one of the pins which are on my large circle. Now, the object of this is to move the thread around as many of the pins as possible. Okay, only in the large circle though, not in the smaller circle. And it goes around. There we go. It doesn't matter if we use all of them or not, but we do want to make a nice pattern there. Okay, so we've still got a little bit left, so let's keep going. Around we go. When you're finished, when the piece of thread has run out, you just need to wind it around several times, okay? So that you'll see the centerpiece is now done. Now you'll do exactly the same, but with the two little ears. So I'm going to do that now. So there we have it, our Mickey Mouse art. Isn't it fantastic? Okay, I want you to try at home too and then send me your results and maybe I'll put it on my film. So have a go. Okay, so today we're going to be going on a virtual ride together. This ride is at a place called Knott's Berry Farm. It's in California, okay? And the ride that we're going to be going on is called Timber Mountain Log Ride. So let's have a go. Okay, so here's the ride. There you see the sign, it says Timber Mountain Log Ride. And it says, if I was getting into one of these logs here, looks like I'm probably going to get wet. Just a second. and we're going to be just floating along this little stream, and we're going to be going up, 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 up into some sort of tunnel or something. We're going up, up, up. Now, if we're going up, what does that mean? We've got to come down. So let's wait for that. Here we have a wheel with lots of water on it. What's it say there? It says, keep hands inside. That means we're going to be going down very, very quickly. So keep tight. Oh, look at that man. All these lovely figures here on the side. They're so realistic, aren't they? Amazing. Look at his face. Wait a minute. I think we're going to be going down very, very quickly. Wait for it. Down we go. Wow. Look at the water splashing. And we're going through the cave, through another cave, and around we go. And I think we're going to go inside the cave now. Let's see. Around we go. Ah, we have some more figures here. We have this man here playing on a guitar. And another one. He seems to be soaring the tree. Look at that donkey! Aww. Very nice. Okay. Through we go. No, if we were in the ride now, we were going to be getting wet. They spray the water on you. And there's another man there working. And through another cave, another tunnel. Round we go. Oh, look at that view. It's beautiful. You can see actually all over the park. Oh, you feel like actually you're on the ride and you feel like you could actually fall out of the boat. So be careful. Oh, look at all that water on the side sprinkling down. If it was a hot day, it'd be really fun to be on this ride. Oh, we're going through the dark, dark tunnel. You see that nice green light at the end. Oh, we're going down really fast. There we are. You see all the water splashing up. Whoop. Oh my goodness. Can't see anything. It's pitch black. There we are. Where are we going to come out the other end? That nice blue light there. What's that? Oh, look. Look at that wolf. He's a bit scary. His mouth is opening up. Oh, and the man in the tent. Okay. Oh my gosh! There's a bear. Oh, and another wolf-like creature. It's a bit scary. And who are these? Oh, there's a man and lady dancing. I think she's doing the can-can. Hey! That looked fun. And he's lying on a hammock. Wow, the design of this ride is absolutely amazing. Whoops, now we're going to be going up, 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 up again. I have a feeling that this is part of the ride when you're going to go down really, really quickly. So let's just see. Going past some more figurines here. Here we are. We're stopping at the top. You see the light at the end of the tunnel. And wow, down we go really, really quickly. Whoosh. Ah! They got sprayed with the water. You see how they got sprayed and the water went up into the camera. Wow, that looks amazing. I think we'll have to go to this park and have a go on this ride. It looks so fun. I hope you enjoyed the ride. Today's magic trick is the disappearing coin. Place my coin in the center of the paper. I'm going to take my magic glass. I'm going to pick it up. I'm going to move it to the center. It's going to hover over the coin. I'm going to say the magic words, abracadabra, and miraculously, it's disappeared. Now I'm going to make the coin come back. Again, I'm going to place my hands on top of the glass. I'm going to say the magic words, abracadabra. I'm going to pick up the glass and with my magic powers, I'm going to make the coin reappear. Amazing. So for this trick, you will need two pieces of paper making sure that they are identical, they're exactly the same. Okay? Plus a pair of scissors, a pencil, a coin, and a glass. So this is how it's done. First, you take your glass and you place it on top of your paper. Then you take your pencil and you draw around the perimeter of the glass. Okay, there we have it. And then you take your scissors and you're going to cut around the circle. Again, you need to be very careful when doing this. If you find it difficult, you can always ask somebody to help you. So I'm just carefully cutting around that circle, making sure that it's exactly the same as the pencil marking that I made. Okay, there we go. There we have the circle. Then we'll move the paper and the scissors to the side. We take our glass and we stand it up. On top of it, we place the circle that we've just cut out. Then we take our tape and we're going to just cut off a small piece of tape, like so, okay? And we are going to tape this piece of cardboard to the glass. You can see that this is a special type of tape which is see-through, so you shouldn't really be able to see it, okay? And then I'm going to take another piece of tape, cut it off, okay? Maybe I'll make that into two to make it smaller. And again, I'm going to take it and I'm going to attach this circle to my glass. Okay, that should do it. Let's have a look. And you will see, you can push down the size of the sellotape, okay, so that you can't really see them. Then what you're going to do is you're going to take your coin and you're going to place it on top of the other piece of paper, which is the same color as the circle you just cut out, okay? Then you're going to take your glass and you're going to place it on top and it miraculously disappears, okay? So that's how it's done. And now we have the fact of the day. Today's fact is about Mickey Mouse and Disney. Did you know that Mickey Mouse was not the first character that Disney designed? Everybody thought he was, but no. In fact, the first character was Oswald the Lucky Rabbit. So that's it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video. I'm really, really looking forward to your responses and seeing how you got on, if you managed to do all the things. I had a great time. I hope you did too. Now, keep happy, keep healthy, and keep safe. See you next time.